Scan on people, I am Chipmunk. Right now you're watching PunchBowl TV. It was amazing. Me and Diddy screwed up. I've done a track with Kalina of Diddy Dirty Money for my album. It's called White Lies. If you get a chance, check it out. But I think the chemistry that I have with these people, you know, these global acts is really starting to, you know, transcend, because if you watch the video for Champion, it doesn't look abnormal, me standing next to Chris Brown. The first time I met Diddy, which was actually through Skepta, shout out to Skepta, he said to me, like, look man, like, you got global appeal. Just never, in the process of you making your music, just try and make the best album you can, but never forget that you, as a UK artist, are someone that I've come across and can say you have global appeal. It's been the perfect friendship, you know, in music-wise and off that, you know, off the record-wise as well, because we're both there for each other and support. And, like, he's one of the people that, you know, when it comes to what he does with words, it's just inspiring for me. And the reason why I will always be able to have the best of both worlds, you know, I can get a phone call from Rich or SAS or Biggs or Sway or whoever to come and do a verse and I can go and kill it. And then I can get a call from JLS saying, come and give me a verse, and I'll know what to do for them. You know what I mean? So it's been that perfect balance. So everything that's happened, you know, from me, Tiny Temper, Tinchy, Dizzy, N-Dubs, it's all been, you know, for the scene, you know what I mean? So that even Devlin could come and, you know, radio won't just see him as an aggressive MC. They will respect that, you know, this is art. What he's actually writing poetry, you know, if he executes it aggressively or not, and his name's Devlin, this is him. Some people have to fight, yeah. The response for Champion was, it's been the biggest response I've had for a song in my life. You know, yes. I'll openly say I'm not here trying to pretend it wasn't a big thing for me, man. It was definitely a moment, you know. Having Breezy on it, it was massive. But the song, how much it means to me, is just like absolutely phenomenal. And, you know, there was so much people telling me, you know, oh, are you sure about working with Chris Brown, this, that, the other. I'm like, listen, man, like, here in the UK, where I am, I know what I stand for. I'm not a global artist, you know what I mean, yet. Hopefully one day I will be. But it's like, here in the UK, I know my fans, and I know they love Chris Brown. Radio-wise, there was a few people saying, you know, they're not going to support the track, TV as well, but, you know, so we put the video on the internet, and it's had like 2.5 million views in a month. This song is a big event, not just for me, but for the UK as well. It's like that. It's, a lot of people are kind of seeing it as the bridge between UK and US artists. I've never been arrogant. I just feel that, you know, if you take a shot at me, I'm going to take a shot back at you until you die. That's me, you know what I mean? So it's like, in the process of me finding myself, you know, I can see why I think just in general here in the UK, confidence is just misinterpreted as arrogance. It's like Cristiano Ronaldo says he thinks he's the best player to ever play in the Premiership, and everyone goes, oh, he's arrogant. But what if he actually feels like that? Do you ever take time to think that? Like, what if he actually believes that he is the best? Why is he not allowed to say it? Because he has to consider how the person who probably doesn't even watch his football matches feels. You know what I mean? The subject matters are very, very different with what's on the album. But like I said, Flying High and Champion, which is the two songs that people have heard so far. So what you have is Flying High, you have Champion, and you know who's on the album. You know, it's making people want to hear it, you know what I mean? And that's what's important for me. I just want people to hear me out, hear my story. You never know, you know, success-wise, it's not my job to market the album, it's my job to make it. Everyone really wants to hear what I have to say. So I'm in a good place, man. I want to change the thing. Hollering at UK and US artists, and the US ones really coming through. There are UK acts on my own record on my album, so it's like between that, and it's never been a thing of me trying to crack America. It's like, you know, I haven't had a press campaign saying Chipmunk's going to break America or anything like that. It's just been me trying to make the best possible album I can here for my fans in the UK. I'm not thinking I'm gonna go to America to perform. Champion with Chris, I'm thinking Chris is gonna come here to my show and perform Champion for, you know, his UK team Breezy fans and my monks. Do you know what I mean? It's like everything's about just trying to make events here for the UK. A whole load of UK artists that I couldn't work with that I wanted to.
Like who?
I won't go into it because I don't look like I'm moaning. Maybe one day I'll tell the world, but it's like, I didn't let it knock me down. I could just had a sick album without anyone on it, and then I sat down with a few people and it was like, who are you into? You know, this album is like the type of sound that you would listen to music wise at home, so who do you want? And I was like, Chris, Trey, Kerry. It was like, go and get him. And I was like, then I actually like had that moment where I believed I could, and I just went for it, and then now look, it's crazy, man. Where do I see myself in 10 years? Honestly, probably having another conversation with you about how the past 10 years went. You know, it's just keep recording studio albums and putting them out, and just cap every time I release an album, I want to capture, you know, somewhat of a new audience. I definitely want my own alcohol at some point. Just trying to go about doing that the right way. But yeah, man, there's just no telling. I like acting, so I might get into that. But yeah, it should be fun, man. I just want to have fun, make music, and just perform for my country, man. It's just a nice feeling to know that, you know, whoever flies in from wherever, you know, when they get to the UK, if you have to name, you know, three names or five names or 10 names, that my name's gonna be in there, man. That's a good feeling. Enough to keep me going, isn't it? Sing it now, I'm stacking my cheddar, I've never been better, it's now or it's never, you know we flying high, I'm stacking my cheddar, I've never been better, it's now or it's never, you know we flying high.